So today I have a special gift to give you as a reader. And my special gift today is a stop sign. So what do I mean by a stop sign? When I'm reading, I know when I do not understand what I'm reading, and I stop and think or reread to help me understand. I have a little monitor inside my brain. And instead of keeping on going and going past the stop sign, the monitor will hold up the sign and say, "Stop, I don't understand this." How do I do this? Well, I keep my mind alert and active when I read. I pay attention to what is happening in my brain and when what I'm reading stops making sense. Maybe it's a confusing part in the story or an unfamiliar word in a nonfiction text. When I stop and try to figure out the confusing parts, it helps me understand and makes reading easier. Let me show you what I mean. So I have an article here from the National Audubon Society, and it's about wading birds. These are birds that get their food in the water. And I'm going to show you what happens when I'm reading this and I stop because I don't understand something. Different wading birds have different for getting food. Well, there's a word I don't know, and I can't pronounce it. It's got a lot of tricky letters, but I can read it with my eyes, even though I can't read it with my mouth. So it says different wading birds have different ways for getting food. Herons and egrets find food by sight, grabbing and sometimes stabbing fish, frogs, snakes, or other prey. So I'm stopping here just to make sure I understand that they're able to get their food because they must have really good eyesight. Now here's another word that I can't pronounce, but I can read it with my eyes, even though I can't read it with my mouth. So let's give it a try. It must be another wading bird. Ibises use their sensitive curved bill to probe in the sand, mud, or grass until they touch prey. Then they grab it. Their diet includes crayfish, crabs, insects, worms, and snails. So just to be sure I understand what I read, it seems that they get their food by touch, whereas the herons and egrets get it because they have good eyesight. And that's what it probably means when they're probing in the sand with their curved bill. And I'm guessing the bill is curved because it's easier to poke around in the mud and grass. Wood storks have similar hunting techniques, holding their large bill partly open in the water until they feel a fish, then snapping it shut to capture the prey. Now, here comes another word that I can't read with my mouth, but I can read it with my eyes. However, I do see the word rose in there, and I'm looking at the picture, and I see that word in the caption. So it's kind of a pink bird. So I think it must mean something to do with being pink. So let's give it a try. Roseate spoonbills have an unusually shaped bill. Instead of ending in a point, it is flared and flat at the end. Now I'm stopping because I'm not quite sure what it means by flared, but I'm looking at the picture and it looks like at the end of the beak, it doesn't go in a straight line, but it's sort of rounded. And I'm guessing that's what flared might mean. It's sort of sticking out instead of going straight. So it is flared and flat at the end, and they find food by holding their bill slightly open in the water and sweeping it from side to side. The bill snaps shut when it comes into contact with a fish, shrimp, crab, or other prey. So you see, as I was reading this, I was making sure that I understood what I was reading and stopping. So now I have a good idea about wading birds, and it's not so hard to read. So remember to put up your stop sign when you don't understand something. Happy reading!